For those of you who I haven't met before, my name is Adam Bergeron. I've been playing here at the Eagle House for almost a decade now.
Almost a decade?
That's right.
Holy cow.
That's about half of my life. This is my good friend Ethan Stone, and I've known him for the other half of my life. Ethan and I go back many, many years. We grew up in neighboring towns about an hour west of here. I grew up in Orange. Yeah. It is. Well, with the way you drive, it's about 32 minutes.
32? I think it's 5 minutes.
So anyways, I grew up in Orange. Ethan grew up in Athol, and we met each other as kids. Wow. We've been doing this dueling piano.
It is an hour. It is an hour.
Yeah, it is.
By the time you wind around.
That's right, it is.
Man, you get stuck out there on the way out to Route 2. It's always...
Not me. Anyways, we've been doing this dueling pianos program for about 7 years now, and when I told Sue that we would be available to come here sometime, she said, oh, absolutely, let's do it. So we're really excited to have a chance to offer this program for you all. We'll do our best to remember that we're here to play music and not just joke and laugh, which sometimes can be a little bit challenging. But it's always such a treat to share the stage with one of my best friends here, and it's a treat to share our program with all of you.
Here you go. That's your check.
Thank you very much. Have a nice performance. He did the same thing to me out in the lobby here. So what we do when we start our programs off is each of us play a few pieces solo so that everyone kind of gets an idea of what each of us does. As you'll probably very quickly figure out, I'm more classical and he's more contemporary. When we first started doing this program, we used to do a coin toss. And I noticed that for a while, every single time do you have a coin?
I don't have a coin, but I thought we could play that age-old game of paper, rock, scissors.
All right.
You know the game? Paper, rock, scissors.
So
like a best out of three.
So I noticed that every time we did one of these kind of games, that I would always end up going first. And then I realized that Ethan had a two-sided coin, and he knew which side to call.
All coins are two-sided.
Well, close enough. All right, rock, paper, scissors?
Yeah, best out of three, because I know you're going to scam me on the first one.
Okay.
One, two, three, shoot. Uh-oh, I'm in the hole now.
I'm going first.
No, we're supposed to do a best out of three.
Best out of three, okay.
One, two, three, shoot. See, he always beats me. He gets to go first. I was going to make him go first.
I was going to say, that's my revenge for the two-headed coin, Ethan.
I like what you call a two-sided coin.
Well, it is. I just can't count very well. That's why I'm a musician.
That's
why someone got that. I'm going to start off with a tango. This was a piece written in 1890 by a Spanish composer named Isaac Albéniz. If you write his name out on paper, it looks like Albéniz. He was one of a handful of Spanish composers at the turn of the 20th century who put Spanish classical music on the international map. And this is by far his most famous composition. It's called the Tango in D. I always offer if folks want to show off their dance moves for this one, well, don't hold back on my account. Now, everyone except for you. Sorry, Ethan.
No, that's okay. You can, yeah, I'll just stand over here. I'll try not to dance. Thank you.
people take me up on that little dance thing, and one was about a month ago. I played the piece down in a performance in Western Massachusetts.
Well, that's not true, because I always try to dance, and then you tell me not to. Tell the story. I'm sorry.
It's okay, Ethan. So the next piece is by another Spanish composer. The piece is written in the very same year, but as you'll hear, the piece is really very different than the last one. In fact, it's really not a very danceable piece, even though it's from a collection of works called The Six Spanish Dances. The composer's name is Enrique Granados, and he was a friend of Albéniz. The piece is called the Minueto.
Thank you.
the folks I've never played for before. And now, without further ado, I get to introduce once again my good friend Ethan Stone, who's going to pick the pace up a little bit.
Okay. Thank you. I'm going to be there. You're not going to let me join the fun then.
That's a pretty old tune right there.
It is. That's true. Yeah, that song was written over 300 years ago. And when it first came out, it was like a hymn. And it's kind of evolved into the anthem of jazz music itself now. So interesting.
Yep.
Okay, I picked that one. Now it's your turn to pick there, Maestro.
Okay, we're going to do some Blue Moon.
Thank you.
I finally got the ending right.
Yeah,
you notice we were both kind of standing there waiting. Is one of us going to play the final chord? Sorry, I couldn't resist.
Okay, that's all right.
Oh wait, that means it's my turn to pick.
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna do a derangement for you. So when I first started playing Scott Joplin's music about 8 or 9 years ago, I couldn't help but play it with a little bit of swing to it. So Ethan was the one that pointed out that's not usually the way people play ragtime music. So we decided to sort of adopt that same standard, and we've added the Maple Leaf Rag to our repertoire, which I'm sure many of you will recognize.
Thank you.
together. Do you think? Give it a little tune.
Sure. We're going to play a little song called The Tuning Song next.
Next week.
So that's a combination of the piece is by Herbie Hancock, but it's kind of a combination of two different tunes that he wrote on the same album. One tune's called Cantaloupe Island, the other one's called Watermelon Man. So we call that our melon mashup.
Yeah, I want some watermelon now that you say that.
It's perfect season for it.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah.
Hey, let's do a little Boogie a la King, shall we?
The Boogie a la King.
That's right.
Thank you.
Reckon, Paul Desmond, and all those guys.
Oh, good stuff. Hey, let's say we do a classical-ish piece.
Okay.
So this is an arrangement that was made many years ago, the Rachmaninoff melody. So Rachmaninoff wrote the piece. He wrote a second piano concerto just over 100 years ago, I want to say in like 1903, 1904. And then probably 30 years later, someone else made another version of it called... Because I never remember what the name of it is, so I was...
Me hoping... either. Rachmaninoff's Piano Concerto in B flat major, number 2. Reimagined.
Right, something like that. So this is our arrangement, or depending on how badly we played, a derangement of the melody. Hope you like it.
Thank you.
Thanks so much. All right, the next piece we're going to do is a piece that I wrote for the two of us to play together. So when we first started planning out our very earliest Dueling Pianos concerts, we had no problem finding contemporary pieces that we were both comfortable with, but we couldn't seem to find classical pieces that lined up, you know, all three tunes that I know in classical repertoire and all 40,000 that he knows. So I decided to write something for the two of us to play. But Ethan said he would only play it if I wrote it for virtuoso and third grader. So I told him I would pretend to be a virtuoso if he would pretend to be a third grader. We're still playing to be 7 years later, so I must have done something right. We call this the Fire Waltz Number 1. Seconds. I think the closest we've come was 70 seconds. But we have so much fun playing this, and once again, it's a treat to share our music with all of you. Thank you so much for inviting us. We look forward to seeing you all again real soon. Whenever you're ready, Ethan.
All right, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3.
again real soon. Enjoy the rest of the beautiful day.
Thank you.